There are few places as special as Africa. Going on a safari is one of the most exciting things you can do. Getting to do it with some of your best friends, well, that makes it even that much more special. This week, Joey and I are hunting with our great friends Tino and Amanda Erasmus of Trophy Game Safaris. This is a hunt you don't want to miss.
Scared because we are quite active. You know, we've got the patrols on the fences on a daily basis, so as soon as there's a track in the area, we know. Like on Friday evening, they were on my eastern boundary, but they don't come in. They use it as a walking line, and we know that they don't know we know of them, but we always know when they're active. And on Wednesday night, they killed two warthogs. I've got pictures of them going through again. I'm just trying to collect evidence, because in South Africa, if we catch them, it's so hard to... I've been so many times in court with them, and it just gets thrown out of court. They just say, not efficient evidence on that or this. They want so much evidence. So right now, we're just building evidence on them. And these guys, there's four particular guys, and they come in with a pack of dogs. And over the last month, every time it's full moon, you can catch them. Last month, they had killed, of what I know, of about 8 warthogs here. And kudu, and they stole my neighbor's what we call a lister machine. It's a diesel machine that runs to one of the water wells for the animals. Last month on full moon, we actually saw them at about 9 o'clock in the morning. The guy came past the camera. We went up there. It takes me about 20 minutes to get to the cameras, and there's a long line along the fence. We could see them about half a mile in front of us, but there's no way we could catch up with them on that distance. So I had guys come in on the front, but I think they somehow spotted the guys, and they started running.
We met Tino and Amanda about a year ago in Las Vegas at the Safari Club convention. So not only was I excited to start this safari, but also to spend time with good friends. On the first day of the hunt, Tino and I decided to hunt for blessbuck. We went to an area of the ranch that held a good number of blessbuck and decided to spot and stalk them in this thick cover.
In the grass, just stay in that spot.
Really nice, yeah.
started out this morning going out for Blessbuck with a rifle and had a great morning. Went out for about an hour today and got this beautiful guy. Shot him at about 100 yards and he went down right away. And this is my trophy.
Wait, where's my kill shot?
That third morning of our hunt, I told Tino, I'd really like to try and get a zebra, and I'd really like to do it with my bow. Now, I knew the odds were against me. These animals are very, very skittish, and they're hard to get. They don't come to water very often, and that's pretty much the way you have to hunt them. You can do spot and stalk, but with the wind blowing the way it was that day, I knew that wasn't an option. So we loaded up, and we decided to head to a blind where he said, held a good number of zebra, and we were gonna sit there that day and just hope we had a chance. We were in the blind that morning and we had a lot of animals come in. We had sable, we had wildebeest, we had eland, and about midday, Joey tapped me on the shoulder and said, look. And I looked out the window and there was a whole herd of zebras. Now, these animals you think would stand out, but when they're back in the cover like that and they're really still, they blend in very, very well. But they were moving our way and I thought if we were just patient, one would finally come in. Well, I think it's pretty obvious who the better camera person was on this trip. After my miss with the old blessed buck, I really appreciated Joey, her professionalism, and how good she did on this shot of the zebra. But I'm not a quitter, and so I decided that after this, I was gonna dive in and try and better my skills and be just as good as her. Day three here at Trophy Game Safaris, and we got a beautiful zebra on the ground. We had animals all morning long. We had sable, we had blue wildebeest, eland, warthog, and we were actually gonna try and take another old wildebeest bull, but he wouldn't give us a shot, and I guess it worked out perfect. You can see I made actually a pretty good shot, and the zebra went 50 yards from the blind, so. Just the start of another great day.
Doesn't seem rotten. Otherwise, we would have had a little bit of it.
All right.
Takes a while to get it.
So after Erin's zebra hunt, he saw what good footage really looked like. That is, if you capture it. So I believed in Erin, and I knew that if he just kept practicing and kept at it, he would finally get how to push the record button. So I gave him some things to go out, take a look at, and just record.
Yeah, probably rifle. It's all spot and stock too, so. Of course, there's a little bit of snow there. I
The next afternoon, we went to a different concession. I had really wanted to get a warthog. I've never gotten one before. So Tomas took us out to this water hole, and he was checking the wind, trying to figure out what side of the water we should sit on. Once he figured that out, we just hid back in the bushes and waited to see what would come. So as we were sitting around this water hole, diker after diker kept coming. And I realized if one came close enough, I'd really like to take it. So I looked back at my cameraman just to make sure he knew where the record button was.
Cool though. Remember how we said we always love character?
Uh-huh. Oh, that's cool.
Another beautiful day at Trophy Game Safaris, and we came out this morning to go hog hunting this morning, and instead I had a surprise and got this beautiful duiker. I love the character of his horns. He has one short one and one long one. I was surprised to get him, and he's beautiful. He's a beautiful trophy, and I can't wait to get him home and get him in our house. He's just a beautiful surprise, and I'm just excited. Erin and I have got to travel to some really amazing places, and one of the things we enjoy the most are the people we meet along the way.
This trip was no different for us. We got to meet Tomas, a gentleman who told us that hunting has changed his life for the better. He started out as a tracker, and now he is a professional hunter through all the hard work of his own. Not only that, he is also giving back to the next generation of professional hunters in South Africa.
Tell us your name and where you are from.
Yeah, my full name is Tinga Hangi Nongovela, but people call me Tom, and I'm from around Utrecht. It's formerly the former homeland called Venda. So that is where I'm coming from.
How did you meet Tino?
It is very interesting one, because first I was working as a labor for the other brickworks. So we were working, doing some old treasure at this gas station, and that is where we met. And I was working there, and he just promised me if we ever we done working, doing the old treasure, if you can come by, we talk. You can have a job, because as young as you are, I don't think it is good for you to do this kind of cement and brick work. So that is how I met him.
How did you get to be a professional hunter?
After working for several years as a tracker and a skinner and just a handyman to Dino, I thought there were times where the opportunity just came and there was some funding where I had to go to the PH school through Dino. That is how I get to be a PH.
And was the schooling part, was it difficult, or was it because you had to go to a different school than a lot of the normal, like, trackers? Didn't you have to go to a more difficult school?
Yeah, for someone who has been out of the school for some couple of years, it wasn't an easy one, but and a lot of stress. But it was hard, but I managed to get through it. Yeah.
And what do you like best about hunting?
Meeting new people, being most of the time in the bush, making friends, and all after all, I just love being hunting.
So tell me what all you do at Trophy Game Park.
I don't know what I can put it, but I do almost everything.
Do you do more than just hunting, more than just tracking? You do a lot of things.
I do a lot of things, because almost every project that is being done here, I make sure that everything is in order, every worker knows what he is doing. And I know what they have to do, so time and time again I have to go and check if they are doing their job good. So I'm looking out to everything, like the one people making the fires, I have to make sure that they make fire in time. There's people fixing the fences, I have to make sure that all the stuff, all their materials are in order and they do it in time. So I have to lay out the foundation for them. So I do almost everything.
And you are teaching some of the new generation of people that are working here how to do a good job as well, because we have some younger trackers and younger PHs here that are just learning from you too. So you are teaching them how to do a good job too.
Yeah, and that is something that I like most, to have someone under me who will teach, whom I will teach to do the job. Maybe if they can be, I will like them to do it better than myself. So I've got some few people here who are still learning, and I make it my point that they learn and they know what to do and they know how to do it best. Like now that we still have, we have Ruan, we have Drivan, and there's still another guy, Ruan's age, his name is Dian. They're still, all of them are still under my supervision. So that is my job.